You also played with Fritz Reiner and William Steinberg.
That's right.
Do you remember what you... Was that always in Pittsburgh?
That was in Pittsburgh. Yeah. Don't remember just exactly how long I had lived in Pittsburgh when I played with Fritz Reiner. I played the Brahms D minor concerto. That's an interesting story. Schnabel was teaching the B-flat concerto in his studio in Berlin. And after the lesson, I don't remember who was having the lesson, but after the lesson, I said to Schnabel, "Oh, you know, I just love that piece. But of course, being a woman, it wouldn't be suitable for me to play it." He said, "Nonsense," he said. "Music knows no sex. You go right home and learn the piece."
My observation of you and tempo, it always seems to me that you never really have to think about it. You simply know what the tempo is. You seem to have an instinct for what the right tempo is.
Well, I probably do have some instinct. But when I find the right tempo, that I consider the right tempo, then I make a note of it on the metronome, actually, so that when I come back to the piece, I'll know what I had thought was the right tempo. Now, I may change it even slightly, but at least I know. And I have a great terror of, as I get old, playing slow. So I'm very glad I have those tempo marks to assure myself that I haven't
slowed down
in tempo. Uh-huh. You know, it can happen. You know, mm-hmm. Serkin's playing very slow now,
uh-huh.
And I noticed that Rubinstein, the last time I heard him on the TV, very much slower and cautious. Well, when I have to be cautious, you know what Schnabel said: dare everything, safety last. So you have to take your chances. Mm-hmm.
You have, of course, continued your career right up to the present day.
That's right.
In 1986, you gave a recital at the University of Pittsburgh, mm-hmm. and I'd like to include from that recital a performance of the Schubert Sonata in D major, Deutschlisting 850.